Today I'm going to talk a little bit about riding your horse and getting them relaxed. Here we have Ali, also known as Cassius Clay, and I started off with some free walk, and then I moved him into a little bit of a more loose trot. I'm not asking him to be on the bit at all. I'm just moving really loose and relaxed. Then I take him into a little shoulder in, which is a three-track lateral movement. And I'll change direction. A lot of riding your horse and getting them relaxed is all about the free walk and lots of changing of direction. I like to use a nice loose rein on a shallow loop, like you see here, where we just bend them to the right a little bit, and then I bent him to the left a little bit, still keeping a loose rein. And I do a lot of walk exercises with these horses just to get them moving forward. So here I'm doing a change of direction with an easy serpentine loop, all the while moving him with my inside leg to my outside rein. So when you change direction, you have to change that inside leg to outside rein. You get a new outside rein. And that's what makes the horse supple in its back. Here I'm doing a 20 meter circle, just moving him out a little bit. I like to just, when I'm in the field riding my trot circles, I'll do a little spiral in, spiral out. And here I rode him from the circle to another shoulder in, down the center line. And always make your horse go straight and then continue. So after you do a lateral movement, always make sure that you get your horse to go really, really straight. One of the things that I've found is that when you have a horse that doesn't want to pick up his canter or he isn't very good with his canter leads, it's really easy if you do a change of direction first. Here I'm doing the leg yield across the diagonal, which is another great lateral movement to get them moving sideways, listening to all your aids, and really working on that outside rein aid being steady. Again, I do a lot of free walk, and there's a difference between doing a free walk on a loose rein and doing a free walk on a long rein. Here I'm doing a free walk on a long rein with a little bit of a connection. And here's our second horse, Sopreso. He's a little bit younger than Ali, but super fun to ride, super trainable. This horse is really, really fun. Again, I start out almost every horse I start out, I just ride them on a really nice loose rein. And then I move into a trot, still not really a tight connection with my hands, but loosening him up. And then I let him just take a nice canter around, and I always start off my canter in a half seat, so a little perched up. And that's just to let their back come up and move freely through their spine on those first few canters. That downward was a little rushed, but I rode through it, and now we're doing a little bit of a trot extension across the diagonal, changing directions a lot, and immediately into a nice free walk. I'm taking this opportunity to again move him across the diagonal off of my leg aids. He gets a little disconnected about here, and just kind of starts evading my leg, but I straighten him up, and this is on a loose rein, so there's really no contact there. So now I'm just doing a little bit more of a collected canter into a trot transition, moving really, really forward and nice, focusing a lot on that rhythm of his trot, getting him to move forward and loose to get that nice springy trot. And the more free walk you can do with your horse to give them a reward, the better. I think that the free walk really solidifies everything. It gives the horse a chance to breathe and to think about what it's doing and really absorbs everything. So that halt was a little abrupt, but he halted pretty square. And he moved really nice and fluid through that transition. Here's a little bit more of a collected canter. I'm just asking him to tighten it up a little bit, have a little bit more spring, but still I want him forward. I don't want it too sticky. He's getting a little tired here, I can tell, and a little unbalanced, as you saw right there in the bridle, but we just continue with a nice steady trot rhythm and he settles back down. Again, same thing, moving into the leg yield there. Very nice, beginnings of a leg yield. And I just really like to use a free walk whenever I can. I think it's the best way to get your horse to just think about what you're doing in that ride, and always give them a really big pat at the end of your ride. Thanks so much for watching, y'all, and don't forget to wear your helmet.